Time is short, so I'm not going to talk too much beforehand about what's in the box. And even if I did, there's no way that I could convey how wonderful this month's selection for the box is. It's wonderful because, particularly, it's very creative. And who's the class that did it? Which class was it? Wow. I'm impressed. So let me first start by saying it wasn't just one thing in the box. There are several things. And they're all pieces of paper. And in fact, there are all kinds of drawings on the pieces of paper. So here's one of the drawings. Okay. Looks like a tree. And a flower and a bird. Okay? It's nice. Here's another drawing. These are at random. Here's another drawing. I can see this one was made by Sevan. Sevan has the name on the back. And it's a crown. And I'll come back to that crown in a minute. And Serena drew another crown. Is it a crown? Yes. And here is another tree. Okay? And it's got birds. They look like canaries flying around in the air. So, but that's not the last piece of paper in there, although that's the last of the students' drawings. Now, I understand the intern did this. Okay, who's the intern? He's not here? Okay. The intern, oh, Musha did it? Oh. So the intern of that class was his teaching, co-teaching with his mother, took all of these elements, tree, crown, birds, flowers, and put them all into one drawing. Very, very nicely done. So can you see that all? Very beautiful drawing that was done. There's the crown, there's a tree, there's little birds flying around, there were other trees. And I said, oh gee, what happened to the second crown? Then I realized that there are three mountains in the background that kind of represent and look like a crown. And then I got to further thinking and I said, you know, this looks like Armenia with its three principal mountains. Ararat, Masis, and Ararat. And the crown looks very much like the crowns of the Arshaduni dynasty, the kings of Armenia and queens who were king and queen at the time of Armenia's conversion to Christianity. And I said, the terrain looks like Armenian. And then I went back to this crown, specifically this crown. Okay, you see the little diamond-shaped thing on the top? I will swear that looks just like the Holy Kevah. But look at the top of it. If you could see it closely, and if you've ever been to Ayastan and seen the Holy Kevah, which is the spear that wounded the side of Christ when he was on the cross, it's kept in a triangular-shaped reliquary, which looks just like this. And I said, that proves that whatever we're talking about here, we're talking about Armenia. And so when I saw this picture, I see the mountains of Armenia, I see the beautiful nature in Armenia, and then I see the crown, and it reminds me of a Bible verse from the Psalms, which says, the Lord reigns. He has clothed himself with honor. The Lord has clothed and girded himself with strength, for he has established the world, which shall not be moved. Your throne is prepared of old. You are from everlasting. The rivers have lifted up, O Lord. The rivers have lifted up their voices at the voices of many waters. The billows of the sea are wonderful. The Lord is wonderful in high places. Your testimonies are made very sure. Holiness becomes your house, O Lord, forever. This is Psalm 93, by the way. All of you will recognize it as Der Takavuyat by Kikunov. It's that same psalm. And it tells us that the Lord reigns. Who is the head of our family? Anybody? Who's the head of your family? You don't know, I'm mom and dad. One and one. But it's not. It's God. Who's the head of your school? No, it's God. Who's the head of the country? That's right, you got it. Very good. Very good, excellent. God is in charge of everything. This is His creation. He made us, and He reigns over His creation. And so I find this particularly important for us today as Armenian Americans to see God's reign in our country of Armenia. And that's very important. I'm not saying that that is what it is at present, but what it could be and what it should be. It certainly was that in 301 when the entire country was shaken by the conversion to Christianity. Hearts opened up, minds opened up. People were saved from their sins. And the country, as a nation, accepted Jesus Christ as their collective Lord, Savior, and Redeemer. And today that is the goal which we all must continue to share with our ancestors, both on a national level and global level, as well as in our communities, in this church, and in each one of your families. We must understand and make sure that in everything that we do, everywhere that we go, everything that we desire to build up, that God reigns there. For He is the King of heaven and earth, the Creator, and the master of eternity. Amen. So who's got the next box?